Hey guys, good morning. Thank you for joining me. The most dangerous thing besides a volcanic eruption would be a hydrothermal eruption there at Yellowstone. I would be concerned. I'm hoping other people there at USGS and the University of Utah are concerned about what's going on at the Norris Geyser Basin, especially with the recent activity with the sawmill complex. Yeah, sawmill has been continuously going off, barely taking a breath to recharge. Yeah, look at that. Several years ago, they closed down this area to tourists. A new fracture zone developed going through this area, and maybe that's why it's recharging so fast, and the eruptions have been so great. In the past, there's been eruptions that lasted up to 4 hours, but not like they're doing now. USGS is only reporting so far in the last 24 hours 12 earthquakes, most of them in the Yellowstone area, the most recent a magnitude 1.7 that they reported at 12:49 and 4 seconds universal time. They are not reporting this earthquake yet, which occurred at 12:51 and 30 seconds. The largest signature and the shortest P wave comes from the promontory. The first signal is pointing up, meaning it came south from the location of the monitor at the promontory. They actually have two marked in red. I'll go to this first one and we'll see what the magnitude is. That comes in as a magnitude 1.88. The second one also comes in as a magnitude 1.88, but it was shorter. It doesn't have as long of a seismic wave as this one did. At 12:49 and 30 seconds, you can see there's actually two earthquakes. Yeah, we got that one there and that one there. They only reported one. So 1:49 and 10 seconds. They're reporting at 4 seconds, so they are off. Let's do the second one first. That comes in as a magnitude 2.04 or a 2.0. Now the first one, we'll go to this one. Actually at 12:48 and maybe 37 seconds. That comes in as a 1.9 or 1.91. So they have a 1.8, not a 1.9. At 12:48 and 30 seconds, the next one they got is not until 10:45. They're saying this one right here is a magnitude 2.4. And look at the heat coming all the way up, all the way up. So that one I come up with is a 2.43. They're being a little bit more accurate than they were yesterday. I didn't post it yesterday, but they were off by a magnitude, maybe a little bit less on all the earthquakes they reported yesterday. You can see down here at the bottom, 2.43. And here you can see it's a 2.4, but it's actually a 2.43. But 2.4 is good enough. Here for the Norris Geyser Basin, this is a borehole 950. I don't see anything for 614, but there is this one right here at 744 that they're not reporting. It looks like to be two earthquakes. We'll do the signature for the spectrogram, and we'll go back and we'll try and see how large these two were. The first one comes in as a magnitude 1.05, or if I shorten the seismic wave, 0.9. Then the second one comes in as a 1.09, and I'm going to make this seismic signature larger to where I pulled it. It probably was actually longer, which would have made it larger. And we'll look at the spectrogram. See, when I make it larger, that's what you end up getting. But they're not reporting that. 7:44 and maybe 9 seconds for the first one. 7:44 and 15 seconds for the second one. Both not being reported. At Little West Thumb, we had a whole series of earthquakes that probably started about 5:52 and 15 seconds. I'll pull this over for you. One of them is marked in red. There we got, 5:52 and 45 seconds. And then another one at 5:53 and about 35 seconds. Some more, series of s'mores, anybody? All right, so let's go over the first one in red, which would be 5:55 and 6 seconds maybe. That's marked in red. And then we got some more. And then we'll come over here to the one that's marked in red at 5:56 and 15 seconds. USGS has one marked at 5:42 and 52 seconds, a magnitude 1.6. So let's go to the promontory. We got 5:42 and 55 seconds here. Let's look at the signature. It's actually before that. The first signature comes in, at 55 seconds. USGS is saying that is a magnitude 1.6, but it actually comes in as a 2.0. Let me pull this down for you, and you can see that 2.0. And we'll go to the spectrogram. So after reporting the 1.6, they don't report anything until 10:45. And you can see there's a series of them here marked in red. We got another one at 5:46. There's a little one at 5:48. A whole series of small ones right through here. 5:53. 5:54. 5:55. And 35 seconds. And then we got this one, which is marked in red. 5:56 and 15 seconds. Yeah, they decided not to report it. Let me close this and reopen it. Okay, and we'll come across so you can see the different earthquakes. Sometimes the image shrinks down, but it does not change the magnitude of those earthquakes. I don't know why the program does that. I'll have to go back over so you can see them all. See how it shrunk it down real fast? Too much data maybe for it to handle. Alright, and then this one marked in red. None of those are being reported along that line. This one here comes in as a magnitude 1.84. If I shorten the seismic signature, we'll shorten it greatly, 1.75. Yeah, they didn't want to report it. And then let's go to this other little one. It's not in red, but okay, we'll go to this one. And then that one. That one probably be easier to figure out what the magnitude is. That one would be at least a 1.47. And then the next one. Yeah, it just kind of blurs into each other. Okay, let's go here. That one would be a 1.93, the next one marked in red. We got another one marked in red, which would be that one there at 4:48. All right, it looks like the first wave came from the south of the promontory. You know, I was thinking, too, that with the technology they got these days and these supercomputers, they would have the ability to have the computer figure out exactly how large these earthquakes are. So going to where it looks like pretty much the seismic signature ended, It comes in as a magnitude 2.06. And yeah, did they even bother to report this? Let's take a look. No, they did not. Okay, they got a 0.9 at 322. So that would be that one right there. Yeah, they didn't bother reporting this one or this one, all marked in red. But they did report that one. And let's go to its signature on the spectrogram. And go back to its signature. Here's a really good example of what they were doing yesterday about taking at least one magnitude off the earthquake, because this comes in as a 1.92. And they're saying that it is a 0.9. They dropped off the 1. It's a 1.92. And its shaking lasted at least 25 seconds. Alright, so let's go back to the ones they didn't report also. Let's see. 340 and 55 seconds. It's marked in red. There's a spectrogram for that one. And shortening up the signature, much shorter than I would want to do, comes in as a 1.75. And then the second one at 340 and 5 seconds. Go back to its signature. That comes in as a 1.87. 211, they reported a 1.1. Looks like they just added more earthquakes to the chart, too. Let's go up and look. Shortening its signature, shorter than how long it actually lasted, it comes in as a magnitude 1.74. Not a 1.1. Even if I shorten it up shorter than how long it lasted, it comes in as a 1.56. If I bring it in almost, well, you're not supposed to do that. It comes in as a 1.74, but you're not supposed to make them that short. You got to give it plenty of room to bring in all the signature. Yeah, 1.77. Yeah, why don't they use a supercomputer to calculate the magnitude? And like I said, the threat for a hydrothermal eruption is far greater than an actual eruption of lava. And to leave that whole area open, they've closed it in the past, and to leave it open is really incompetent. 1249 Universal Time is the last earthquakes they're reporting, and you can see, and you can match up many of these to show that they are across the board. And even though this one here is all the way over at Norris Junction, and this is at Little West Thumb, and here on the right is the promontory. Here we have a current view of Yellowstone Lake. This is taken from by the fishing bridge from a cell phone tower. They got a camera up there. 8:50 Mountain Time. This here is Stevenson Island. I want you to take notice of this. This here is an image of all the earthquakes that have occurred within the last week. Up over here at the top, that's Stevenson Island. Down here, we got Frank Island. We got that crack going through. Let me go over to Google Earth. So this is Frank Island. The triangles I tried to draw out was from research back in 2018 of hydrothermal vent fields. If I was them, or one of these researchers, I would send a submersible down here to see what is actually going on down here by Frank Island. That's just me. In December of last year, they had a swarm of earthquakes over here on this side of the map. I marked a lot of them out. And then the recent ones, I only marked out the 2.0 or greater earthquakes. And that's what all this is through here. These are all the recent. I have not bothered to put the close to 500 earthquakes that have occurred within this area, and also over here in the same area of the earthquake swarm of December, 8 months ago? Yeah, they're using satellites to view, evidently, what's going on with the heat. But I would put a submersible down there, or even take a boat out and drop some equipment over the edge of the boat to see what the heck is going on down there. Maybe they have and they just aren't telling the public. You know, they are also taking live gas readings. And we should, the public, it's our tax dollars, should have access to those gas readings. What are the gas readings at the park? When I first started getting into volcanology, that was because of the eruption of El Hierro by the Canary Islands, and the Spanish government had available for the public, you could log online, all the live gas readings of all the islands as they came in. Spain is not a rich country like the United States, so if Spain could put available online for the public to see the gas readings that were coming in before the eruption of El Hierro, they could do it here at Yellowstone. They have the equipment. You know, and I knew by watching El Hierro within 2 weeks that it was going to erupt by watching the increase of the gases that were coming up from the ground at El Hierro. I had a 2 week notice that it was going to erupt. So if we had those gas readings now, we would know if Yellowstone, in fact, was going to erupt, and if it was, how soon? But see, Yellowstone is a super volcano, and it would crash the stock market. A lot of people forget about the 120 nuclear power plants that are here, just alone here in the United States, that would go and melt down because the ash would short out all the power stations, the power lines, and all they have is backup generators to keep the systems cool, keep the rods cool, but they're not meant for long-term use. So, there would be a panic, and they want to bring in every dollar they can bring, stock it away into their black budgets, their secret programs, for themselves to escape to some foreign country if they knew that Yellowstone was going to erupt. They want to decrease the world's population as it is. Yeah, it would be an E.L.E. event where only certain people in the know would know. Looks like they got a little boat out there at Yellowstone right now. Anyways, what are your thoughts? Please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your support. I greatly appreciate it. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.